Hey, where you? Hey, this is Hey, where you at, bro?
Nigga, you know I got kicked out that bitch. You wanna go on the internet making up stories and shit, little hoe?
Come meet me. Hey, come meet me at the same spot right here. Hey, ain't no cops, no nothing, bro. We can just shoot ones on my mama, nigga.
This nigga right here, nigga.
Hey, where you at?
Nigga, you already know where I was at, bitch. You got me kicked out, little hoe. How you gonna run up with eight?
You got choked out with your bitch ass.
Nigga, you had eight niggas and you had your own security choke me out, nigga.
I never was my security niggas fuck with me, you bitch ass nigga, cause you was nobody.
Nah, nigga. That's your security, nigga. Who the fuck hired security to go to a hookah lounge, my nigga?
Where you at right now? On my mama, nigga, we don't need to argue, bro. That's female type shit, bro.
Nigga, you the one that's calling me and texting me. Nigga, you see me and didn't do shit, bro. Nigga, I was wide open. I was wide open in the club, you didn't do shit, nigga. You had your chance, nigga. You got your 5 foot security to choke me out, my nigga.
You a gay ass nigga. How you gonna come pull up at somewhere and don't do shit? You a bitch ass nigga.
Nigga, you had all that time to do shit, nigga. You hid behind your girl, nigga. Hey, tell your girl to check the DMs too, nigga.
Where you at? I told you to wait for me after the club, nigga.
You bad as fuck.
Move the car back.
You a doofy, my nigga.
The fact that he called you and said that.
Bro, look what time it is, my nigga.
That was four hours ago.
Nigga, stop calling my phone and you had me wide open at club. You got your 5 foot security to choke me out, my nigga.
That nigga's hilarious.
And he's bro, not sure gonna wait for me after.
He had eight niggas, bro. Didn't do shit. His own security is the one that choked me out. And then he had a chance to get McQueen. Didn't do shit either in the club.
Yeah, we was all in the club chilling, nigga. And I was like, you know, look, I got it on foot. So I don't even need to explain shit.
Don't even need to explain, my nigga.
That shit's funny, though. Hey, Chris Sales, bro, you are fucking hilarious,
bro. You were, bro.
I fucking love
you. You get the Oscar of the year, bro. Like, without a doubt, my nigga. I aspire to be. I want to be just like you when I grow up, bro. Straight up, my nigga.
He's still here, like that shit happened two minutes ago.
Right, Chris,
you are amazing.
You could have kept that same energy, my nigga. Damn, oh, I'm just...
Man. And he's at the same
energy. I don't give a fuck what he said, bro. Chris is the ultimate YouTuber of the year.
No, he said this shit like you came at him. Like,
right.
Like, he was like, you came out here, you pulled up, like, pause. You walked in and saw it.
Bro, I don't give a fuck no what they said, bro. Christian just won all the Streamy Awards, all of that shit. That nigga's the greatest YouTuber to ever live, man.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, man. Chris, Christopher Sales. Flight team, stand up! We got some extremely late controversy on Houston time, you know what I'm saying? Anybody happens to be awake, man, you guys are in for a treat. I did not even mean for this to happen, you know what I'm saying? Niggas living this life. We in Texas, you know what I'm saying? FTC. And basically, man, to cut the long story short, because I want to get onto this interesting reaction, and that was just spammed to me as soon as this was uploaded. I got, you know, some people were DMing me saying, oh, this man Chris Sane, this nigga Flight got jumped and choked out by his gang, and he was caught slipping, and that's another L. Tragedy for Flight. He can't stop taking L's. I will. Oh, guys. I just wish, you know, Chris... He really could have honestly took a big W. Like, I could have... You, Chris, my nigga. You could have walked out tonight with the free walking W shirt, bro. Like, literally saved you so much money, bro. But, you know, you just... On certain things... First of all, man, if anybody believes that Mr. Sales is anything gangster to a certain extent of what he seems like... He deserves definitely an Oscar award. He's definitely gonna win an acting Oscar award of the year for how he's just, you know what I'm saying, going on about. But basically, to cut a long story short, man, me and my dog McQueen was invited to this club. It's like a hookah lounge club in like Houston called like Club Therapy or some shit like that. It's just, or therapy, whatever the shit is called. I don't know if it's club. But anyway, man, it's therapy. We go in that bit. It's a little lit, you know what I'm saying? As we were invited by like two females, okay? So cut the bullshit, man. We going straight to the story. This nigga Chris Hill show up like 30, 40 minutes into the thing we was in there, man. We already had a section. We was vibing. You know what I'm saying? He shows up with like 8, you know what I'm saying, to be exact. Maybe there was one more. But I felt like it was definitely like over 7, without a doubt, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, carrying on, this nigga fucking has all these dudes, and me, I'm just looking at this nigga Chris, you know what I'm saying? And I get McQueen, I'm just like, yo, this nigga Chris is here. And then Chris, this nigga Queen pulls out his camera, and he starts recording. You're gonna see like some fire exclusive vlog footage, you know what I'm saying? You tell me, you know what I'm saying, if anything got super close to what he was even talking about, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, man, I hope somebody that was at that therapy club, please, like, if you have footage, like, please show the proof, like, with the choking part. That was actually true, you know what I'm saying? But I was very disappointed that you twisted it. You like, twisted it like a whole slinky, you know? And you went the extra mile that you shouldn't have, Mr. Chris, man. I really was rooting for you, bro. I was even thinking about it, too, as soon as I got booted out. Basically, man, Chris and all of his crew show up, and instantly, Chris is just starting to talk his mess. He's like, to me, what you looking at? What you looking at? I'm just sitting there. I'm just like, what's popping? Like, and he's with Parker. I thought they fucking broke up or some shit. Like, he's with Parker. Parker's fucking, like, staring the kid down. You know what I'm saying? Check her DMs. Queen's sitting there chilling, recording, you know what I'm saying? His crew is literally talking hard bullshit, cash shit. Mind you, it's like 7+ niggas against 2. Because we was with females, but females, they're not gonna fight. So it's basically 7+ niggas against 2. They're talking for 5 to 8 minutes. No punches are thrown. Nothing is happening. Now, there's a security guard, a bouncer, another security guard that comes. It's like 3 of them, okay? And they're continuing to talk Chris and his gang, nothing happens, and then the security guard, which was my fault because I didn't notice because this nigga was like literally 5 fucking feet. Like, he was up to here. So, when I'm ever in a hostile situation, I feel like, and anybody's like really about to like swing or about the fight is about to go off, I just go in defense mode. So, I feel a nigga stepping literally on my shoes. I got some fucking like heat on. This is some pure cocaine heat, bro. Some off-white Air Maxes, bro. You already know what time it is. So I'm instantly like, I put my elbow. I didn't like do like on his chest, but I'm like, put it on. I'm just like, bro, you need to back up. But as soon as I said that, he was just like, oh, who you talking to like that? You talking to me? I noticed he was a security guard. I was about to apologize, but I was like, at this point, this nigga trying to like seem like he's trying to prove something and get tough. It was a bad decision on my part. Maybe I should have changed the way my tone was to the security guard. You know what I'm saying? But mind you, this nigga Chris has 7+ niggas. He had security in a whole hookah lounge, my guy. You know what I'm saying? Mind you that. And as soon as they come out, that's when they want to start talking crazy and get more harder and everything. And then when the security guard is in my face, we're going back at it and forth. You know, he fucking gets me by my neck. And yeah, I got choked out and grabbed in a headlock and thrown out the club. No, I didn't pass out. They kicked me off the whole premises, and I had to call my Uber. The Uber came, and I waited outside of my Uber for like 10 minutes waiting for McQueen to come out. McQueen had to go upstairs because like the cops, the other two people that was behind the bouncer that kicked me out when he choked me out and shit. You see that mark and all that. I did not get jumped by Chris's gang. I did not get choked out of that fantasy GTA 5 Mission 77, whatever fairy tale he wanted to present, you know what I'm saying, to the internet. You know what I'm saying? I apologize to you guys that it didn't go that way. I know, I even wish myself, that would have been just awesome, just constant. Flight reacts, gets jumped by 7 guys, and he gets choked out. Oh, man, but yeah, man, I'm sorry, guys, that didn't happen. But yeah, I technically, if you want to say, I did get choked out on some real nigga shit by that bouncer dude who was 5 foot. He knew some MMA shit. He kicked me out, you know what I'm saying? The kid was good. I didn't pass out. Called the Uber, waited in there 10 minutes. McQueen came down eventually, and then we all booted. And then on top of that, while I'm in the midst of everything, this nigga Chris is texting me, like, talking about, like, oh, I'm a pussy, and all of this, da-da-da. And I reply back saying, like, oh, you know what I'm saying, nigga? It was 7-on-2, you pie ass, you know what I'm saying? And you guys can see the text, man. I'm just, you know? And he's just going on and on, like, bro, why are you talking crazy now? When you had all that time to swing on me in the club, or even not even you. Yo, niggas just won, bro. But anyway, bro, I really want to check out this nigga Eurasia shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? To see what he has saying. We're gonna go through the thing the entire time. They had it. What? Did they say he had a do pick and? Bruh, come on now, man. How realistic does that sound? You know what time it is right now. If I passed out, don't you think I would be in a hospital? I wouldn't be functional to make the video this late, bro. This doesn't even make sense. I thought he was about to say I was wearing shorts. I was about to stand up real quick. You know what I'm saying? And wearing pants. But these guys are some fucking comedians, bro. They are some comedians. By the way, I have texted him back. I texted him back as soon, you know what I'm saying? On this other shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? Just talking all this crazy mess. Oh, man. Bro, if you're ready to fight, you fight right then and there. Why do you gotta walk outside? What is this? I don't know how y'all was raised, but that's not how what we do. If you wanna strap with somebody, you strap right now. Why do you gotta take it outside? You know what I'm saying? Keep that same energy. And then you also notice on the phone call too, when he called back, when I was with those two girls and that guy and McQueen, you know what I'm saying? You notice how fucking loud he gets on the phone? Like, my God, he was not anything near that in person, bro. At all, bro. Like, I actually, like, he's not posting nothing. What are you posting right now? He posted it on a Snapchat, I think.
Hey, honestly, bro, I feel sorry for Flight, bro. That nigga came. Look at my nigga Jordan out here. I wish I could show y'all that nigga getting choked out, bro. If I had the footage, I think somebody got the footage that nigga Flight getting choked out.
But upload that bit.
That nigga McQueen ran upstairs.
Oh, that's him.
Yes, nigga. My nigga Daniel.
Bro, he ain't run, bro.
My nigga Daniel was about to beat that nigga ass, bro. My nigga Daniel ran up to him and started shaking him. God, nigga.
I'm parking to check your DMs, Chris.
But yeah, that nigga was scared, bro. Hey, next time, bro. Scared, bro.
Chris. There's no way he can take this serious. Is there anything else he's saying? Man. Mr. Christopher Sales, man. I'm just disappointed, bro. You had a chance, you know what I'm saying, to really prove yourself, you know what I'm saying, right then and there in the club, and you let your own bouncer, you know what I'm saying, your own security or whatever you want to call it, you let them handle the work while you talking all this wreck, and then also on top of that twist in the story. Oh, man. But like I said, man, the kid is good. Nobody passed out. Yeah, the kid definitely did get choked up, you know what I'm saying? That 5-foot nigga had some MMA skills, you know what I'm saying? But it's all good and dandy, bro.